this house, first of all, feel like it's a bit haunted. Like, because me and my, you know, my coworker, we'd be talking about the house being always cold and all that. So I was like, something is off about this house, first of all. So me, JJ, take me, JJ, baby, oh, JJ, love me, JJ, do me, JJ, take me, JJ, baby, oh, JJ. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Kukwatisi, bienvenue sur ma chaîne. So for today's video, we are back with a little spooky story time. And this story time is about my sleep paralysis. First of all, before I didn't know what it was, I had to do some research and find out what it really was. And I realized that it was actually sleep paralysis. Nothing like, because in my head I was like, oh, someone is trying to kill me in my sleep. Anyways, you guys will find out how everything went on and, you know, how the sleep paralysis happened. From my experience, I have actually had a couple of them. Actually, it wasn't like my first one, but it was my most recent one. Okay, so today is November 1st. Halloween was yesterday. As you guys can tell by my voice, I'm still like recovering from a cold, so I could not push this video out by Halloween. Hopefully I can push it out by this evening or tomorrow, Saturday. Okay, so yeah. First, before we get started, you guys already know, don't forget to hit the subscribe button down below. It's free, it helps your girl a lot. And yeah, and you make sure you stay updated with the video that I upload. Make sure you turn on your notification bell so you can get notified whenever I upload the video. You guys already know YouTube be playing with us. So yeah, and definitely check me out on my social media platforms. That's Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat. It will be in the description box down below for your convenience. And yeah, let's get started. So guys, this is actually the first time I film using natural lighting on this new setup that you guys know we have going on now. And I actually like it. Based on the mirror on my camera, I see that you guys can see me well and the lighting is nice. So I hope, you know, it's the same when I actually upload the video. But yes, I like this, like, get into this lighting, okay? Period. But yeah, first this happened, I was actually at work. Like, work, guys. I was at work and I was taking a quick, you know, a quick nap on my the couch at my job. Mind you, I work in the home, so it's easy. Like, it was nap time for the people I was working with. And so I was like, okay, while I'm taking a nap, let me catch a couple of, you know, minutes of sleep as well. Like, I was like, let me just sleep a little bit, you know. Mind you, I'm the type of person that I'm a light sleeper. Like, if anything happens around me, I'll wake up. And I also like when I sleep, if I sleep somewhere that is not my bed, I'm pretty, like, alert. That's the word. I'm pretty alert. So, in my head, I was, okay, yeah, while that's taking the quick, you know, nap, I'm going to go ahead and take my nap. I fell asleep, right? First of all, I was on my phone because, you know, I watch YouTube videos. Really, if I'm not home, even at home, sometimes I do need to be on my phone to sometimes, like, fall asleep and stuff like that. So, like, I'll just be scrolling on my phone. So, that's the same thing I was doing at work. I don't like watching TV, by the way. If I watch TV, it's because somebody's next to me watching TV or someone put a show that they were watching and then they left it on and I just stood in front of the TV. Like, I really don't like watching TV. TV is not really my thing. So, yeah, like, the TV was off and I was on my phone. The people I was working with were in the bedroom. Mind you, they like taking naps. So they, and mind you, the naps are long, but I was like, maybe 45 minutes of nap in and I'll be good. So I'm on my phone scrolling, watching YouTube video, boom. I fall asleep, right? So I'm sleeping, you know, while I sleep. You don't know what happens, you know, in your sleep. I sleep. And the next, you know, I found myself trying to open my eyes. I open my eyes, okay? Like, my eyes are open. My eyes are open. I try to move my arm. I can't. I try to move my leg. I can't. But my eyes, I can actually see from side to side. So in my head, I'm like, Jesus, what is going on? Like, is my spirit leaving my body? Like, what is going on? Like, I tried to scream. Like, I felt like my mouth was open, but the words wouldn't go out. Like, I was like, but the words wouldn't come out. Like, I was like, but it wouldn't come out. And mind you, this is not the first time that I have had a sleep paralysis. So whenever that always happens to me, I pray in my head. Mind you, words cannot come out. So I start saying prayers in my head. But before that, I was really trying to get myself out of that stage. So I was trying to move. Nothing was happening. And I was getting frustrated because I was really pushing myself to, like, move. Then when I go like that from the corner of my eyes, I can swear I saw one of the people I work for. They were sitting in the dining room. Mind you, I'm laying down on the couch in the living room. So I believe they came down and sat in the dining room for like a few minutes. Like, based on what I remember from looking on the side, I think they sat there for a few minutes. Then I was still trying to get myself up. I don't know what happened or why the person I work with sat there for a few minutes and then looked at me, turned back around. Mind you, I work for people, you know, that need assistance. So I'm like, why are you looking at me like, come help me in my head? That's what I was telling myself, like, why is she looking at me like that? Like, you need to come and help me. Mind you, my voice is not coming out. My eyes are open and I can see around what's going on. Then next you know, the person I work with gets up and go back to her room. So she goes back upstairs. So at this point, I'm like, okay, so I guess, I guess I'm dead. Like, something's happening here. Like, it's after this time that I decided to do my big research and really found out what the heck was going on. Because the couple of other times that it happened to me, I'll actually do a story time about those times, like my very first sleep paralysis up to this one. I can make a series for those that are interested. So make sure you just let me know down below in the comment section. And you like this video to show me that you actually want those story times. And also you subscribe, okay? All right. So, yeah, so in my head, I'm like, oh, heck no. Like, this is not it. Like, this is not it. Like, something is really going on. Like, either I'm dead or I'm dying. My spirit is leaving my body. Or this witchcraft, some type of witchcraft is going on. Like, some type of voodoo. Like, no. So, in my head, I start praying. Mind you, I told y'all, every time this happened to me, I get so terrified and I start praying. So, in my head, I'm saying, God, please help me. Whatever is going on, let that come out of my body. Whatever spirit is taking over my body, let that come out. Lord, please help me. Please help me. Normally, I just got to say a couple of words and I wake up from the sleep paralysis. But this very day, I don't know if it was because I was sleeping on the couch. And normally, it happens to me when I'm in the bed. But this very day, it took more than just a few words calling God to help me for me to get out of that stage. I started panicking even more. Mind you, in my head, I'm going crazy because I see everything that's going on. And I know what's going on around me, but my body is just not moving. So this time, I'm like, please, Lord, you normally help me when I go through this. Please, Lord. Like, I'm praying, calling all the God, calling the Virgin Mother, calling Jesus, calling every single body I know in my head from, you know, the Bible and from my religion. So finally, after a while, mind you, normally I would say a few words like, God, help me, please. Take me out of this stage. You know, whatever's going on, Lord, please help me. And boom, I wake up. But this time I had to say a couple of, you know, a couple more words, a couple more sentences, like calling for help, you know, calling my spiritual God to come and help me, you know. So until I finally got out of it, I finally can move, right? So I get up. I look at that couch. The couch looks at me. Like, I look at the couch. The couch is like, I'm like, bro, like, what is wrong with you? Like, in my head, I'm telling this couch, like, what is wrong with this couch? Like, something must have really been wrong with this couch. Because for me to have such a long sleep paralysis than usual, I was like, nah, I'm never sleeping in that couch again. Like, that couch, something is wrong with that couch. And that's what really pushed me to start doing research. The house I work at is so dark naturally, like, and it's always cold in there. So in my head, I'm like, this house is haunted. So I was like, let me start doing my research, because at this point, like, it must be something going on more than just, like, you know, me thinking I can't wake up, you know. So I was like, before I was like, oh yeah, maybe it's my body not being ready to wake up, you know, when that was happening before. But when I was like, okay, no, let me do my research, and I finally found out it's called sleep paralysis and all that jazz. So yeah, now I know what it is. But that day was so scary. Like, when I woke up, of course, the person I work for wasn't there. She was really in her room sleeping. So I'm like, did I really see her coming down, or it was all in my head? To this day, I don't know, but I think I saw her coming down, and she looked at me, then went back upstairs. I don't know. Yeah, y'all, I believe she did that. She came, sat in the dining room, looked at me, turned around, waited like for a few seconds, and went back upstairs to bed. I don't know. I think that's what happened. Based on what I saw that day, that is what happened. And yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. That day was so scary. Like, I had to call my friend. I called my mom. My mom is my best friend. Like, I don't know what I would do without my mom. Like, that's Mommy Duke. So I called my mom. I told her about it. And she laughed at me, because it's not the first time that happens to me. But she was like, you know, what were you doing sleeping, first of all? Like, you were supposed to be up. I'm like, Mommy, I just need a couple minutes in. Like, I need to, you know, recuperate to really continue working my shift that day. So she was just laughing at me. She was like, you know, just do your research. But I was like, mommy, I'm gonna look into this because something is wrong. Like, I had had this couple of times, but this time around, this house, first of all, feel like it's a bit haunted. Like, because me and my, you know, my coworker, we'd be talking about the house being always cold and all that. So I was like, something is off about this house, first of all. So I need to do my research. Oh, my dog is next to me. Yeah, I need to do my research. So, yeah. But that was the last time I had sleep paralysis. And this happened probably, like, over the summer. Like, this summer that just ended. So, yeah. Sorry about my voice once again. I got a cold. You guys, I already told you guys I'm recovering from the cold. And I got my black on. You know, it got a blue on the side. But I got my black on, you know, since Halloween was yesterday. And since it's a spooky story. So, yeah. Don't forget to follow me on my social platform. That's Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat. It will be in the description box down below as well. And also, I'm looking for somebody to make me, you know, the handle with social medias. I had someone that made that for me before, but I can't find her contact again. So if one of you guys want to make it for me, DM me on Instagram, and I'll definitely use your services. So yeah, and I can't find the one I used before because, mind you, I cleared up my computer storage, so I need new handles. That's why I make sure I include my social media platforms in the description box down below. And definitely make sure you also subscribe to the channel, subscribe to your girl, because that helps me a lot and shows me that you guys are actually like following along. Comment down below if you ever had a sleep paralysis or any spooky dreams or that of that sort. I love you guys, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Bye.